Hi there, Jim Beckler with the RV Corral. Hey, welcome to our website. I'd like to take a few minutes to show you a brand new 2017 Keystone Cougar fifth wheel. This is a 279 RKS, so it's a double slide rear kitchen model, kind of a mid-range, mid-profile type fifth wheel. Good layout, you'll see once we get inside. It's got a nice floor plan. Very easy tow. This is part of the half-ton series, so they're fairly lightweight trailers. You don't need to have, you know, a huge truck to get it around. In fact, as far as towability goes, Keystone does a lot of things to help improve on the towability, like the cutaway front end. Notice the molded front cap has corners cut away for a better turning radius, so you don't hit the front of your trailer if you turn it too tight with your truck. Obviously, if you have a long bed truck, you'll never have any issues with that. But if you do have a short bed truck, you know, that can be a little bit more of a concern for you. Obviously, we recommend that you have a sliding hitch just in case you happen to get into a tight spot. But point being, you don't really have to worry so much about that contact from the front of this trailer to the back of your truck when it's contoured like that. They give you a little hitch vision feature here also with the light. So it actually reflects from the trailer to your rear view mirror. So if you're looking in your mirror, you can see the back, the front of your trailer here as you're backing up. Make sure you're lining up properly. Even has little LED light strips in here. So we move around to the front of the work utility side of the trailer. You can see you have two slide outs over here on this side. Nice pass-through storage area. I like the fact they put a magnet up there now, so you can just put that up with the slam latches. It falls right into place. Nice pass-through storage. Opens up really well. Got plenty of storage to put all your stuff. Your tank control pulls are inside here, so they're out of the weather. This unit is equipped with an auto level system too, so you've got a way that you can level out your trailer without having to block everything up. So once you pull into your spot, disconnect from your truck, you hit this auto level feature over here and it will level itself out, take care of it all for you. It really makes it nice, much easier, less problem. Even has a feature that will has a memory feature. It'll go back to the spot when you go to pull your fifth wheel back out. It'll go back to the spot to where you hooked up to your truck. I like the fact you've got these controls inside here too. So you've got your black tank flush, your fresh water fill connections right there. Outside shower area even has a satellite prep connection right here. Battery disconnect makes it nice too. So if you're going to store this, you can disconnect. You're not going to draw off your batteries to drain your battery if you happen to leave something on. Got propane tanks on both sides. They split them up to make sure that the weight's distributed the most effectively so you don't have towability issues. Our storage compartment up front here also, that's gonna have your batteries. We're gonna make sure you have two brand new batteries in the unit when you come to pick it up. Great little layout in here. Even has a little place there where you can put some hoses or miscellaneous things you can hang up in there. I like the fact that it has a solar. I'm going to drop this down real quick, Ben. I've got a little solar system already. It's all wired for solar. You could use this for portable solar panels out here, docking lights. Really makes it handy in case you're doing this at night. So we go around the patio side. Look down the side, you can see that it does have a nice fiberglass finish. Frameless windows that fit nice and snug against the side of the unit. Look, has a nice fresh look to it. Outside speakers. Great patio awning, has a large patio awning. Notice how you don't have anything coming off the side to kind of break up that awning area, so you can pretty much utilize that whole side, this whole side of the trailer for your patio. Again, another propane tank in here, and then another access on this side to the pass-through storage. You've got some plug-ins right here too with the light. This is welded aluminum framing, so you've got a nice quality construction, keeps the weight down, put together really well. You can just see how it's all finished out in here really nicely too. Even the pass-through storage area is finished nice with this kind of a more of a felt type of a finish. Plus you've got same type of finish on the walls here that you have inside. This is a really well insulated unit too. These are pretty much an all season type unit. They're 0 degree tested, so they actually have an outside company besides Keystone that tests these in 0 degree conditions. They put them in cold conditions for I think up to 72 hours at 0 degree temperatures to make sure that everything's not going to freeze up on you. So they pass the test at 0 degree for up to 72 hours. So as long as you have your furnace on, you've got radiant heat down below there. Plus they put that astrofoil insulation underneath your tanks too to help protect the tank. So that's fully enclosed underbelly, so you have a nice protected area down there for your tanks and water lines. I like the fact it's got the lend-a-hand. This is really nice for getting in and out. New steps now, they come out with a little different type of step. That's really, it's got the little the chrome steps. A couple things I want to show you back here. I mentioned this is a rear kitchen model, so you got a nice little window back here too that opens up in the kitchen. It is already wired up for a backup monitor. Has a ladder to get up on top, has a full walk-on roof, so if you needed to get up there do any maintenance, you can get up there without any problem. Has a full walk-on roof, and it's a one-piece TPO roof, so it's very low maintenance. I like the fact you've got your power core right back here, 30 amp service. This bumper also slides out, so you've got two pins that you can pull, slide the bumper out, gives you additional storage back here. You can put bikes back here, maybe firewood. You could even maybe you dry camp a lot, you might throw your generator back on here when you're hooking up. Let's take a look inside. Let's start up in here. So it has a side aisle coming up into your bedroom area, so you have a private bath. Nice walk-around bed, queen-size bed with storage underneath. So you've got good storage underneath there. I like the headboard. They've got a place up in there where you a little shelf where you can put things. It has plug-ins. I think it has a charging station on one side and a 110 outlet on the other. Even has a nice shelf up there. So you've got nightstand with a couple drawers, storage up above that, and then more closet space back in here. One of your slide outs is a closet, so you've got all this additional closet space here also, which makes it nice too. You've got more place to put your stuff. You have access to the bathroom from the hallway and also from in here, so it has a Jack and Jill type entrance into the bathroom. As we come through here, you see part of this closet's going to be in your bathroom too, so you've got a place where you can put towels. Porcelain toilet bowl really makes it nice. Again, more of a residential style feel to it. Nice stand-up shower. Nice corner shower. So put the light up above, or skylight up above, let in some light. Again, this is all ducted air conditioning. The furnace is propane furnace, so you got good heating and air conditioning in this unit. Lots of lights, lots of plug-ins. Take a look downstairs. Nice big slide out on the utility side of your trailer. I guess your driver's side is going to be the side that's going to have most of your hookups. That's kind of what I consider the business side, your hookups and that type of thing over here. But nice deep slide. You can see it's about pretty close to 3 feet deep. Lots of windows in here. You've got storage in the slide out also. Lots of lights. This is what they call a tri-fold sleeper, so it's a sofa that makes into a bed, folds out very easily. The dinette also makes into a bed, so this one you can drop the table down, fill in the cushions, and you've got another bed, so you've got two beds in here plus the bed upstairs. And then lots of storage underneath, so both sides of the dinette open up for additional storage. Even has little cup holders back there. I think it's nice that not only do they put big windows in the slide outs, but they also have the ability to open them up. Some manufacturers you'll look at, you'll see that they just have solid windows and they're not as big. You don't have the ability to open these up. So this, you could actually open both sides and get a nice flow of air. Rear kitchen area gives you a lot more counter space, more cupboards. So you've got good storage back here. If you like to cook, this might be a good floor plan to consider, because you do have more kitchen area here. And little carried away there. That's a nice storage. Lots of cupboards. Comes with a microwave. You do have a 3-burner stovetop with larger size. I say large. They make a couple of size ovens that they put in the RVs. One's 22 inch, one's 17. So this is the larger of the two. Again, more storage down here. In fact, you've got a nice removable sink cover. Two stainless steel sinks. Kind of a residential style faucets, actually. The refrigerator is gas and electric, and it's freezer up on top. This is an 8 cubic foot. They put a little bigger refrigerator in here in the last couple years, so they upgraded the capacity for that. I like the fact this one has a nice pantry right next to it too, with more drawers over here. Notice the drawers are full extensions as they come all the way out. They put a nice heavy-duty metal glide, so actually I'm pushing pretty hard on that. You can see it's not moving much. It's got a good, solid feel to it. They're more like a residential application. Has a nice little recliner also, with the TV up front here. Flat screen TV. It's already set up for playing movies, so you can slide in a DVD, watch a movie. Maybe you just want to listen to music, it'll play your CDs also. Great little setup. Controls are easy to get to here for your slide outs, for the awning out there, your hot water heater, water pump, all that's right here. Lighting, even check your tank levels. It's just kind of nice to have everything in one area, easier to get to. It's close to the door too, so you can just pop in here and kick that awning out or whatever the case may be. Really great floor plan. Again, it's 279 RKS, part of the half ton series. So give me a call. You could reach me at 541-510-1017. Again, my name's Jim Beckler, and be glad to help. So if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks.